Okay, so now I'm talking to Leo from Australia.
Yes, you are.
Welcome to our conference here.
Thank you.
So what will be your topic in this Dean's conference here?
Oh, my topic will be across everything that a Dean does.
Oh.
Because I work at an institute that actually tries to train academics to become academic managers.
Mm-hmm.
And so that includes deans.
Okay,
includes heads of schools.
Sounds interesting. What do you do in particular?
Well, we are funded by the Australian government to improve management and leadership across the tertiary education sector, which means that we work with all the people in the universities
mm-hmm.
to sort of build their skills and knowledge on how to become better at management without stifling the institutions. So I'll have a job for the rest of my life, I guess.
Yes. So what are your experiences then in Australia in the last few years?
Quite good. I mean, it's a completely different system from the European ones where I was coming from. I'm originally from the Netherlands.
Mm-hmm.
And as we heard in the introductory speech,
yes,
that is a very peculiar system. But some of the elements there are the same as what we find in Australia.
Okay.
So a notion on appointing people to management positions, having expectations about them, how they perform, still trying to work in a collegial manner, but realizing that there's a lot of pressures out there. And in Australia, unfortunately, we've got far less money in higher education than you would have in some of the European countries.
Oh, I wouldn't have.
So there's
that.
A lot of stress on the system.
But if you see it on an international level, is there an international competition?
There's a huge international competition.
Yes. And what's the role of the faculties then in that?
One of tension and stress.
Can you give us an example?
Well, it becomes very difficult when we sort of talk about increasing our student numbers, you know, 20-25%.
Okay.
Whilst not increasing staff numbers, because we don't have the budget for that. So it just means doing more with less, which at the faculty level, of course, raises all sorts of questions of, look, I've got to teach all these students, and you also want me to do research, and you want me to go out there and get some money. When do you think I will sleep? Work-life balance and all those kind of issues. So that puts real pressure on the dean as the one who has to moderate all of that and try to, on the one hand, keep the faculty happy, on the other hand, keep the senior executive happy. So it's becoming increasingly difficult.
Not an easy job to do.
No.
And in this competitive position, are there also ways to cooperate then on the international level, more like cooperation within the competition?
Yes. The famous word of co-opetition.
Yes.
As it actually is called.
What are your experiences there? Can you practice?
Clearly, because we're at the end of the world, we try to get out of the end of the world and collaborate with people in both the Asia-Pacific, in Europe, in the United States, and you see a lot of mobility there, and people, you know, trying to set up research partnerships, trying to get into joint research projects, trying to even get into truly international partnerships. So one of our universities, the University of Monash, has partnered with the University of Warwick in the UK to set up truly joint programs, where actually staff is half appointed in Melbourne, half appointed in Warwick. So, I mean, it's a perfect example of
fruitful cooperation.
Cooperation rather than competition, because they pool resources and try to create something that's unique as a brand.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much. So we're glad to have you here and also to have cooperation with you in that international field here. Thank you very much.
Fantastic to be here, and thanks for all of that.
Thank you.